Biden expands military operations in Afghanistan amid withdrawal crisis. Appearing yesterday at his first White House press conference since the fall of Kabul, U.S. President Joe Biden tried again to play down the historic and humiliating blow suffered by the U.S. and its allies in their 20-year neocolonial war in Afghanistan. At the same time, he said 6,000 U.S. troops could stay in the country beyond the August 31st deadline agreed with the Taliban on the pretext of rescuing U.S. citizens and selected Afghans. "I think we can get evacuations done by then, but we're going to make that judgment as we go," Biden said. In an attempt to put on a show of strength and stability, Biden was flanked by senior officials, including Vice President Kamala Harris, Secretary of State Antony Blinken, and Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin. Biden vowed that not only all Americans in Afghanistan but everyone who had assisted the U.S. military and wanted to leave would be evacuated. "We're making the same commitment to Afghan wartime helpers as to U.S. citizens," Biden said. "This would mean a dramatic expansion of the military operations." U.S. officials later revealed that military and intelligence operations were being mounted in Kabul and other parts of Afghanistan. Austin told House of Representatives members in a call on Friday afternoon that Americans had been beaten by the Taliban in Kabul. The defense secretary branded the beatings unacceptable. His comments conflicted with Biden's earlier statement that there was no indication U.S. citizens had been unable to get to the airport.